Hello everyone, welcome to Easy Classes. This video complete guide to create Google Forms. If you want to create a form, surveys, participant feedback or invitations, thanks notes using the Google Forms, you will find all the details about that. Let's start. To open the Google Forms, go to Google Chrome first. Open the Google Chrome. In Google Chrome, search for Google Forms. Press the enter key. In the search result, click on the first link. In the window, there will be a button, go to Forms. Have to click on that. Google Forms already have some ready-made templates. If you want to create an event registration form, you can directly click on this and make the changes according to your event. T-shirt sign up, party invite, event feedback, contact information, like this. These are all the ready-made templates created by Forms. If you want to create your own form, means we have to go to blank form. I will show you how to create a blank form. So click on this blank form and form is opened. First we have to change the heading. You want to say thanks in the form, or if you want to get the feedback from the participant, or you are making some surveys, whatever the heading of your form, you can just enter here. I am making some feedback form. After that, form description. For what you are getting the feedback from? You organized one event. If you want to get a feedback for that event, you did an lecturing, you want a feedback from that lecturing, like that. You have to give a description for that. I will enter event feedback. After that, next, questions. You want to ask the user to questions. In the feedback form, what we want? First, we want name of the person who is giving the feedback. So, I'll enter full name. When we enter the full name, it's showing options, but we are not supposed to give the options to the name. It should be a short answer when we enter the name. So here is the attributes. We can change the attributes according to our questions. Name should be short answer. So I'll select this short answer. Here another options also there. Paragraph, multiple choice, check boxes, drop down. According to question, we can change these options. So next question, we have to add next question. So to add the next question, here is the add question option is there. This is plus symbol. Just click on. Here we can ask person about their hobbies or their date of birth or occupation, like that, depending on your event or class. So here I'm just entering hobbies. This is also short answer. For hobbies, there is no multiple choice. It should be short answer. It's automatically changed. Again, we want to add. This is the add question again. Here we want to add one more question. Gender should be multiple options, no? So like male, female, or here one of other option also there, other, like this. These are all multiple choice options for gender. After this, if you want to give an again on heading, like this is basic information. Next, you want to collect feedback about your program. So that time we can add another heading here. In this shortcuts, this is add question shortcut. This is import questions. Means you already have one old Google form. You want to import some of the questions from that form. Means we can use this button. This is add title and description. Same like in the heading. We can give another heading here. To do that, we can click on this. So we can give another title. Like now personal information or about event. Description is optional. If you want you can give the description, or else you can leave it. After that, you can add again some questions about event. You can give how you feeling. This is also multiple questions. Good, bad, happy, sad, Also, when we enter multiple charts, there will be one adding the image option will also highlight. Sometimes your charts could be your images. See, now are you feeling it's good? Instead of good, we can add an image or emojis. If you have already in your laptop, you can browse and upload it, or you can directly search from the Google and you can add it here. For good, happy emoji face, bad, sad emoji face, like that we can add this one. And here also option is there, add image, means we can add an image and according to that image we can ask some questions to the users. Same like video, we can add the video in the form. Add section means if you don't want visible all the questions in one section, we can divide the form into sections like part A, part B, section A, section B, like that we can do this. Also, one more option is available for every questions. Duplicate question. If you want to duplicate this question, no need to write again. If you just press on this, same questions will come. After that, you can change the choices or you can change the questions accordingly. If you want to delete this question, you can click on this. Required means if user don't want to answer this, but if you want to make the user answer this question, enable this. Required name is required. The person who is filling the Google form should enter the name, so we can make this field as required. So when any person filling the form, he should fill the name. Without filling the name, the form will not submit. Like this, hobbies, gender, for every questions, this whatever the question you want to enable the required option, you can enable it. Like this, you can create the form according to your need. Then this is next tab, responses. When you share the Google form with the users, participants, whoever, when they will give a response to your form, those responses will come here. Link to sheets means we can import those information into Google Sheets. I will show that off. Here, make this is a quiz. If you are a teacher, you want to create one quiz in this Google form, you can enable this one. So that when give any marks to particular answer, like that means it will automatically do from the back end. Responses, how you want to collect the responses. Is collecting the email ID, who is submitting the form is necessary or not. Do not collect. If you want to collect, you can give verified or responder input. If you want to send a acknowledgement to the users who submitted the form, you can on this one. After submitting, if you want to allow the users to change their response, you can enable this one. Limit to one response means if sent on Google form link, they submitted the form. Again, if they want to submit the form, it will not come if we enable this limit to one response. One person can submit the response once only with that link. Presentation. Manage how the form and responses are presented. Means user is filling the form. So if you want to show the progress, means how many responses he submitted. If you want to show this to user, you can enable this. And shuffle the question order means when you send the link, the questions order will be different to the different persons. If you want to do that, you can enable this one or else leave it. Confirmation message means when any person submitted the form, they will get this message, your response has been recorded. If you want to change that message means you can change that one. Same, we enabled this limit to one response, that why it's disabled automatically. After that, result summary, user can view. Form default settings applied to this. Same, email address we given, do not collect. If you want to make all the questions compulsory, so we can enable this one. No, if not means we can enable that required option separately. And here some of the options are available. This is creating the form. This is customize the theme. Click on that. Here you can enable means how to look of the form, means what color you want to create a form and what is the background, or if you want to upload one image like company logo, like that means you can choose image, you can browse from the your computer also. You choose means it will look like this. Preview. In preview we can look how a Google form will look to the users. See, this is how your form will look like. Undo, redo. This is the responder link, means we can copy the link after publishing. We can give it to this link in any social media so that any person can submit the form. Here regarding means publishing the form, whom and all you want to send these form, we can add the mail IDs. Click on publish. When we click on the publish, it will create the link. It's published. After publishing, here it will come copy with the responder link. Responders, who and all the responders, I given anyone with the link. If you don't want, means you can give whom, like any particular mail ID, persons only can respond to that link, like that you can give. I will copy the responder link. If you, it's long one, if you want shorter, click on this, it will short the link. Just copy that one and you can paste it anywhere in the social media. It's published, this form. How you will receive the responses? After receiving the responses, how it will look, I will show you in the example. Go to back. This is my old form. This is the forms I created. See, one person is responded to this form. So it's showing responses are one. When we click on that responses, it will give the summary, means what is the responses, what is the question, for what question, what is the answer, individual. If we want to view this information in the sheets, we just click on this view in sheets. It's exported to Excel sheet. After that, you can directly download this Excel sheet and you can maintain it. This is how Google Form you can create and manage the responses and make the settings for your Google Forms. Hope you like this video and found helpful. If you are new to our channel, please subscribe and hit the bell icon for more videos. Thank you for watching.